Hi friend, welcome to GeoEntire. This is again time to share one more video with you. So today I am going to share a video on the basis of history of geophysical prospecting. So this entire part I am going to share in this video. So geophysical prospecting consists of different methods. It includes electrical methods, in which resistivity method, then magnetic method, cell potential method, and other different methods are there. When man knew the use of metals, then man began searching the mineral deposition from which he could win the ores. He was not content with taking what he discovered accidentally. In older time or in olden days, prospector was not merely a man of adventure. He had good powers of observation and was intelligent enough to note the correlations between soil, vegetation, topography, and rock formations favorable for the occurrence of mineral deposits. Even where surface indications were lacking, attempts have been made from a long time to gain knowledge of hidden mineral deposits by using instrumental devices. In order to locate concealed deposits, various methods have been tried. Some of them, like the divining rod, are without any scientific basis, while others employ some physical or chemical property associated with rocks and minerals. This type of scientific exploration may be said to have had a beginning about 1640, when the compass needle was first used in the search for iron ores in Sweden. Where the surface is covered by glacial deposits, the idea of utilizing natural electric currents present in association with the sum of ore bodies as a means of ore detection. It is put forward in 1830 by Robert Fox, who carried out investigation in Cornish mine in England. The suggestion for a gravity meter to measure relative values of gravitational attraction at different locations on the earth was made in 1833 by Sir John Herschel. However, the measurement of gravitational fields for prospecting was not put on a practicable basis until the introduction. Torsion balance by Uatois in 1902. The torsion balance, the concept using artificially produced earthquakes by explosion to gain knowledge of the nature of the subsurface strata, came from Robert Mallard's investigation in 1860. There are different ideas. Numerous workers, principally in Europe and America, began to develop sensitive portable instruments for measurement of physical quantities, and used them to obtain information about subsurface conditions. Up to the 1925, some of the methods of prospecting were zealously guarded as trade or professional secrets to many companies and individually, with the result that only merged information was available. The merged information was available to general scientific world. However, the publication of Elements of Geophysics by Ambaron in 1928, the Robert on the Imperial Geophysical Service in Australia by Brockton Edge and Labby in 1931, the excellent collection of papers on geophysical prospecting issued in this journal articles. So, American Institute of Mining and Metallurgical Engineer from 1929 onwards, the publication of Geophysics Monthly Magazine of the Society of Exploration Geophysicists since 1936, and also a number of papers in other engineering and scientific societies, brought about a keener appreciation of the value of the publicity, the scientific information. This publicity simulated discussions and help help to promote research and development. Improved instruments and techniques of measurement and interpretation have continued to follow from time to time, with benefits from to the mineral industry and to the profession of the prospecting. So the development of geophysical methods is concerned. Important techniques were introduced during the two world wars. So during World War I, a sound ranging techniques was developed to locate the position of enemy guns. Soon after, vigorous attempts were made to apply the principle to design instrument for the seismic prospecting. This method of prospecting has played and continues to play a very prominent role or part in the search for petroleum deposits in the world. During World War II, what happens? The airborne magnetic detectors were designed and successfully used for the location of enemy submarines. Further improvements made soon after the war produced refined methods for magnetic exploration from the air, enabling rapid surveys of blanketed and inaccessible regions. Electronic engineering was harnessed not only for the instrumentation in many of the methods of prospecting, but also for computation and prospecting of data. The radio methods of fixing positions have been adopted for offshore and aerial surveying. Airborne magnetic, electromagnetic, radioactivity methods have now become common. Electrical and seismic methods for investigations in civil and military engineering and other allied projects were also introduced during these years. Geophysical prospecting has become not only a profession but also an industry in itself, particularly especially in USA. In scientific prospecting alone, USA has more than 400 to 500 parties operating on contract, both in that country. In many other countries, including Russia, there are number of geophysical parties, must be several hundreds in all other European countries, Canada, China, Australia, and also have many geophysical parties. In the Indian subcontinent, the first geophysical exploration was carried out in 1923. This is also based on the geophysical surveys conducted during the next 15 years, where almost entirely depend on the devices or services of other European or American firms. In 1938, the Mysore Geological Department started a geophysical unit to carry out electrical surveys for the location of sulfide ores and also for investigation, engineering and groundwater problems in Mysore state. In 1945, the Geological Survey of India organized a geophysical section at Calcutta. After independence, this section was strengthened with additional staff and modern instruments for all the principal geophysical methods. There has been further expansion of the section during the second, third and fourth 5-year plans, and there are also more than 300 geophysicists now working in GSI. So Geophysics Directorate was organized in the Oil and Natural Gas Commission, that is the ONGC, at Dehradun in 1956 with a nucleus of officers from the Geological Survey of India and training of a large number of probationary geophysicists. In subsequent years, this directorate expanded a great deal, and there are new 12 gravity magnetic, 26 seismic and 18 well logging practice. About 500 geophysicists in all operating in the various sedimentary basins of the India. A geophysical section was organized in the Central Water and Power Research Stations at Pune for investigation of engineering projects. The Atomic Energy Commission has been carrying out, that is, the scintillometer survey for exploration of radioactive minerals. Geophysics department have been organized for teaching and research in the universities of Andhra, Banaras Hindu University, Osmania University, Roorkee, and there are different IITs including Kharagpur, IIT Bombay, then ISM Dhanbad, then and NGRI, that is the Research Institute, now having established a well-developed geophysical prospecting laboratory. NGRI, Osmania University, Hyderabad, furthermore, the government of India have created a new department for airborne mineral surveys and exploration to tackle an integrated program of exploration style, that is the Operation Hadra. A large volume of useful geophysical results has been obtained from these various organizations and also by some of foreign geophysical firms employed by private companies for exploration in their concerned area. For a long time, comparatively little was known about India's petroleum resources, and there was an impression that major oil fields could hardly be expected in this country. From the results of the geophysical prospecting or exploration, these impressions was dispelled. The discovery of the oil fields of the Naurkatia, Moran, Rudrasagar and the Lakpa fields in the Brahmapura Valley are the fruits of geophysical exploration. In an even more impressive way, we can say that successive has attended the geophysical exploration in Cambay Basin, which for a long time had been thought of a having little or no prospects for oil. The geophysical exploration in this basin has resulted in the discovery of the important oil fields of Ankleshwar, Kalol and Naugam, and the gas field in Cambay. Several other fields have also been found in this region, some of which are like the food produce of oil and natural gas. So geophysical exploration has also been carried out in India for location of deposit of other minerals such as ores of copper, then lead, manganese, chromium, gold, diamond, graphite and radioactive minerals also. A fair measure of success has been achieved in locating some new deposits and in showing continuation of some of the already known deposits. Although these discoveries do not appear spectacular, they have proved useful additions to our resources of such minerals. Furthermore, geophysical investigations have played an important role in tackling bedrock foundation problems in civil and military engineering purpose or projects connected with dams, bridges, tunnels, location of construction of material and concealed ammunition magazines, etc. and also adding groundwater supply projects. So I hope this is how the geophysical exploration prospecting are developed in the world as well as in India. So I think this video is useful to you. So in this way, I'm going to add one by one a lecture on this. If you like my video, share and subscribe my YouTube channel, that is GeoEntire, all about the earth.